So let me just show you the procedure that I'm doing to cut these. And I've got my Festool track saw, and I'm using the I'm using this 1.9 meter track, and this is a fantastic size for anybody that, like me, that does Baltic birch. It just gives you, it lets you deal with a full piece of Baltic birch 5x5. It's not too long that it's obnoxious to work with. I've got the other one that comes with the track saw, and then I've got a shorty that I also use on my thing. I've got the connector so I can connect them all together, but this is really a brilliant thing. I think they make this thing, oh my goodness, I think they may make it like, you know, 4 meters long or something, pretty, 5 meters, I think maybe 5 meters unbroken. But if you need to deal with stuff, awkward stuff like this, instead of trying to do this on a table saw and you're a small shop, this is just the ticket. You'll see this here. So I just want to give myself a nice straight edge here first. Just going to go ahead and take right from this corner here, you know, just, and this is my sterret, this is my sterret straight edge, very, very accurate, and I'm just going to use this guy here to extend my line and give me something to really pull to. It's just simple stuff. What you do is, see, I've got my miter gauge here. I mean my sliding T bevel. Not my sliding T bevel. See, it's late. It's late and it's hot. I've got my combination square protractor head, and I've got it set to 63.4 degrees. So I've got it up there on my nice smooth edge, and I'm going to pin this down like this, and then I'm just going to walk this into it. I want to clank it because I'll move it. So you just walk it right into it and then slide it edge to edge, and you're gold right there. So I see absolutely zero mark, zero distance in between the two. And then I'm just going to pop a hand screw on this. And then just to be sure, I'm going to just give myself the right pencil line. That's rock solid right now. Get this guy out of the way. Bring my track saw up. I need to go back to 14.5 degrees. Put a little support up underneath that corner. Okay, so
And I also don't need to cut the whole length. So what I want to do is just cut halfway. And a sheet of Baltic is 153 and a half. So 75, 76 and a half. So something like, somewhere like right in here is where I'm going to stop. And it's not going to probably be that long, but I just don't want to be wasteful. I'll be able to use that for something else. When you've got an interior cut, you can see how effective the dust control is versus trying to cut on the edge where the dust is not channeled up into the unit. Okay, so that's let me do a measurement off this other one and move my fence around. So I'll move my fence around this way. I'll just go ahead and get it kind of pre-positioned so you can see what I'm talking about. And I'm always cutting on the interior of the piece, so I'm actually kind of cutting these upside down because of the way this thing tilts. So I'm gonna make my next cut like this. Okay, so I've got the got my exact mark put over here, and I took into account the bevel, and so I've got my pencil line drawn there. So let me bring up the sterret. This thing's got such sharp edges, it's awesome for this kind of work because it wants to kind of grab and bite into stuff. It's a fantastic tool. Okay, so I think I'm set. I got to get up on top of the table for this one. Oh, no, I guess I'll just cut backwards. That's fine. Pinched. wouldn't have enough support up underneath it here. Done. This is why I like having both styles, because that handle can get in the way when you're right up against table edges and stuff. That's why this one with the little Acme screws sure is nice to have. Really handy. I guess it doesn't really matter. I'm going to cut it anyway. Well, no, I'll leave it because I got to trim those at 14 and a half. Go check this one and see how it fits.